Linda Yuki for her personal intentions, and from Kamodo's family, it is a thanksgiving, and also we pray for the family. Today is a birthday. Guess whose birthday it is? Church over 2,000 years ago on this day, Pentecost was decided. It is, and through all those years, can you imagine the millions of people who have longed to be with God and live with God because of the ministry of the church? It is our time to do what we can in the church, for the church, in the name of God. And indeed, closer and eventually enjoy being with our Father in heaven. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The Lord with you,
and with your spirit.
And to prepare ourselves to celebrate the Lord Jesus, let us call to mind our sins and ask for God's pardon and strength.
Confess, O Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in
sanctifying your whole church and every people and nation. Pour out, we pray, the gifts of the Holy Spirit across the face of the earth. And with the divine grace that was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, fill now once more the hearts of believers. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Envy, drunkenness, carousing, and the like. I warn you, as I warned you before, that those who do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such there is no law. And those who belong to Christ have crucified the flesh with his passions and desires. If we live by the Spirit, let us walk by the Spirit. Let us have no self-conceit, no provoking of one another, no envy of one another. The word of the Lord.
Oh,
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Counselor comes, whom I shall send to you from the Father, even the Spirit of truth, who proceeds from the Father, he will bear witness to me. And you are also witnesses, because you have been with me from the beginning. I have yet many things to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. When the Spirit of truth comes, he will guide you into all the truth. For he will not speak on his own authority, but whatever he hears, he will speak. And he will declare to you the things that are to come. He will glorify me, for he will take what is mine and declare it to you. This is the gospel of the Lord."
Sometimes we have had occasions where
somebody has found a phone in the church. Then you came to the church, you put your phone somewhere, then you forgot it, then you went away. Somebody finds it, brings it to the office. Father, give me kind of happy. Understand? Then you're saying, that's good. That person would have taken it and gone. And you could have gone and see, thanking God for stealing and leaving you alone. So people can do that. But this person, even if you've not seen, brings it and says, it's a found there. That person had a voice speaking home to him or her in the heart. It's just the way it is. Or you know you have done something wrong against somebody, and yet don't feel any peace. What is happening? In yourself, you know it was bad, and so you have no peace. So it bothers you, and you feel you have to go and apologize. And you have no peace until you go and say, please, can I talk to you? I did this to you, and I'm very sorry I did that. Please forgive me. And then you are told, okay, well, journalist, I'll forgive them. That day you leave there feeling what? Feeling free, feeling lighter, because you know you are forgiven. When the law of God is written in our hearts, then we can do the right thing. Of course, we need faith, it's true. But even when we faith, we have a conscience. The conscience is that voice that speaks in you that makes you feel about uneasy. It's not the right thing. It's not the right thing. And you want to do the right thing. And so, do that. Today we celebrate that. Pentecost. The coming of the Holy Spirit on the apostles. And it's for us the birthday of the church, like we are saying. Okay? Now, Pentecost is the reversal or the changing of what happened in the story of the Tower of Babel. You remember the Tower of Babel? The Tower of Babel, where people thought they were very clever. And they come on, they can get out there and then get hold of that God out there. He doesn't sleep, he can always get to him. And so they thought that building a tower and just making tall and dark, they'll get there. And then God looks at these two fellows. And what does he say? He changes the languages. And then all of a sudden, there's chaos. There's chaos. That chaos that was produced by Babel is reversed. Or the possibility of its reversal is by accepting the work of the Holy Spirit. Because when the Holy Spirit, therefore, rules our life, becomes part of our life, then we have one language that is common. That language is called love. And the language of love is international. It doesn't depend that matter whether you are Asian, African, European. The point is this. Kindness is what? It's kindness. Forgiveness is forgiveness. Helping a poor person, you don't know how to speak their language. All you have to do is see a need and provide that need. And that's it. That's it. Now listen to today's second reading here. What are we told? Paul says, walk by the Spirit, and do not gratify the desires of the flesh. And then he proceeds to say, the works of the flesh are plainly immorality, impurity, idolatry, sorcery, enmity, strife, jealousy, drunkenness, dissension. All those things are parts of the of the flesh. And the works of the Spirit are the following that show that it is the Holy Spirit. Please get this. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Those are the signs of the presence of the Holy Spirit. And this is important for us to understand. Because sometimes we may be taken in by thinking that the presence of the Spirit is when we speak in straight front. Do you want me to speak in the Spirit? Now, I shall have my going on. Have you hear the meaning. But what does it translate into? Because whatever is the Holy Spirit, there is the interpretation of the voice of the Spirit. As I hear it, the same as I hear it, you can translate that. You can be speaking the same meaning. All I made as I want, some noises. But we can use them to confuse people. So that my life does not show the presence of the Spirit, those gifts you have seen there. But then because I can say this strange thing and claim it from God, then I can make people believe that's the way it is. But remember, where there is kindness, as a sign of the presence of the Holy Spirit. Where there is forgiveness, remember, as a sign of the presence of the Holy Spirit. But if we speak even in those tongues that are strange, and we are drunkards, how are we going to hold him? There is no law. Drunkardness is a sin. That's how. Where there is all those things, enmity or sorcery. Sorcery refers to uchari. Remember uchari? Now uchari is called me, so uchari is called me. Because there is the Holy Spirit and there are other spirits. Okay? You may have been brought up in a tradition where there was lots of belief in that. It's true, you could be a victim of that. But you have a responsibility of opening your heart that the Spirit of God may take control. And then those things that you are taught when you are growing up about to Uganda or child, you may say it's the work of the Spirit, but not the Holy Spirit. Some other spirits. And normally they're not used for good. Because there is a lot of belief in that. Isn't that so? And you see these days in telephone posts, what are you seeing? Or electricity posts, what do you see there? Doctor. And quite a meeting. Business, your training, your business in the Itawale. I figure he's single numbers. That's not the Holy Spirit. That is some fellow claiming to have some authority. It doesn't work like that. We are of the Holy Spirit. And in fact, when we are removed from that, that's a captivity. And it's true, you can be happy for that. Like I said, you may have grown up innocently in a place where you believe all tribes have the child's memory. So most of us are brought up like that. But the point is, when we then receive the Lord, then those are the kind of things, because when the Spirit of God comes, that which is good in any ethnic group is confirmed, which is godly. And that which is not good is washed away. And every ethnic group has that. Nothing, no group was pure. So our acceptance of Christ means a reversal of those things that we may have been taught. So, Pentecost, therefore, brings about understanding where Babel brought misunderstanding. Today's gospel, or today's fast week, rather. Today's fast week, these people are there. And then the Holy Spirit comes and begins to speak in different languages. And they are understood by people in Jerusalem who came from all corners of the world. And they are able to understand that to the extent that they are all perplexed. And these all men from Galilee, how come they are able to understand all this? And they are speaking in other languages. That's the power of God. So where there was division because of whatever differences, now all of a sudden things are coming together. Where there was disintegration, division, because of A, B, C, D, all of a sudden people are finding it changes people. Or when we receive messages from other people that are encouraging you to do things that are not good, love tells you, God, don't do it. Or if love makes you go slowly, you take another message. Like I told you earlier one time, I thanked the Lord so much when we had the last elections. And there was trouble. Oh, I knew the elections. But I remember this, you know, our parish here, we still have about 3 years going, and we still came to church. Do we have a junior here that is a tribal junior? They're all together. And even when there was those messages of the field out there, here, we did not. How can we explain that? I can only explain it by the fact that the Holy Spirit living in us that makes you know Mama Joki, Nieto. Mama Chien, Nieto. Baba Kwai, Nieto. That's all you know. Otherwise, if the Holy Spirit in us, those are the spirits, tribal spirits have been there, what would you have done? Other you can't see anything. See your father in Kanja. Kanja is in the group. Oh, Mama Krista. That's what you have said. Simple as that. Because there are other voices out there telling you about the ethnic group, being there, this or that, yeah. But for you, you haven't there because you knew who we are, who we are. And we are sons and daughters of the one God. And that's what we celebrate today. The power of love. The power of Jesus Christ, the equalizer. Who makes the difference that we have as human beings not be a source of conflict, but be a show of the glory of God. It's always beautiful when we have these different ethnic groups and each brings their own style together. We enjoy each other. We get a lot of fun. But in the hand of the devil, the differences can be a source of death. And we have seen that happen. Racial fights, games, the hatred, all those things, is when we allow that spirit of evil to empower us. Now, Christ himself told us, in John chapter 20, verse 22, we are told how Christ gave this. He breathed on them. We are just showing the instance where we heard about how the Holy Spirit came. We are told he breathed on them, received the Holy Spirit. Those who sin to forgive are forgiven. Those who retain are retained. Because any good work done in the church is the work of the Holy Spirit. And he also told in John chapter 16, verse 7, he says, if I do not go away, the Holy Spirit will not come. Why would Christ say so? Well, the other thing that he was here, please remember, Christ was here as a human being. So in his humanity, he was limited. So if he was in Jerusalem, then he was not in Galilee, in Bethlehem. But the Holy Spirit has no boundaries. He is here like we are today, and he's somewhere in Pakistan, and he's somewhere in Latin America, he's there at the same time. And this Spirit was one who helped to write the law of God in our hearts. So he chose and said it is good that he goes, because when the Spirit comes then, and we have to propagate the gospel, doesn't matter when we are propagating it in, it will be the work of God. He must simply come and introduce to us the love of God and prepare us for the reception of the Holy Spirit. And that the Holy Spirit that Romans chapter 8, 10, chapter 8, verse 15, 17, Paul says, you did not receive the spirit of slavery to fall back into fear. You have received the spirit of adoption that makes us cry, Abba, Father. That is the spirit that we have to get. Confirm him. Affirm him. Remind yourself that already he is in you. Because sometimes you may be very blessed, but if you are not aware of the blessing, you will act like somebody who is not blessed. And you'll go away crying and mourning. Who the blessing is already in you and you have not taken the time to do what? So without knowledge. Same thing. Remember, you are baptized in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Remember again, it was repeated during your confirmation. Yes. But it is your responsibility, my responsibility, to acknowledge that, to keep that fire burning. And that means that I have to do something positive. Like, for instance, maybe in the habit of prayer every day to wake up with the Lord and to give time to God. By doing that, then we are keeping the fire of the Spirit alive. Otherwise, it is possible to receive it, to have it, and live your life like you never knew it, or like it never existed in you, because you don't have the consciousness of it. But when you are conscious of the fact that He lives in you, then it is possible to depend on Him and even to benefit from and in His presence. The Holy Catholic Church started during Pentecost. Through all those 2,000 years, millions and millions of people have gone to be with God our Father. Let us pray for the Church, and it will continue to do that good work. Let us pray that the leaders of the Church and the Christian fraternity worldwide will be always open to the Spirit, that even when people go off a little, that they will, their conscience will help them to come back to the fold, so that the Church, the Christian Church, that doesn't become an occasion for business, like some people call them kiosks. The house of God is not a kiosk. It is the house of God. Where people come to be taught by God, to be reminded, to experience the love of God, and to walk with each other. Because Christ is the head, and we are members of His body. You have a part to play in the body of Christ. And through you, somebody somewhere will find life. Imagine this. Imagine that when you are with God in those days, when we go to heaven, somebody tells the Lord, this man, this woman, is the one who welcomed me into the Church, encouraged me to come to church. Let me give you some more mark. Think of the people that you know in your neighborhood. People you know, a shopkeeper, businessman, or lady, or whoever it is, who doesn't go to church, doesn't bother about church. Imagine yourself welcoming them. Don't worry about giving them faith. That is not supposed to give. That is the gift of whom? Of God. But He can use you just by welcoming somebody. Welcome to our church. Welcome to church. Invite them. Let them come. When they get here, or here, because they will be taught, they will listen to the good news, and please God that somebody's life will change because you cared enough to invite them to the house of God. The Spirit would like all of us to have that kind of feeling of wanting somebody to come and taste and see that the Lord is good. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
He came down from the
Thank you, Jesus, for sending us the Holy Spirit to be our strength, to be our guardian, to be our consoler. Holy Spirit, work in our lives. Always give us that sense of conviction, that sense of presence, so that we will not be afraid to do the right things that we know we should do. Sometimes we are ashamed or too weak, or sometimes simply unwilling to do the right thing. Lord, give us. We welcome to offer you prayers.
Our response to our prayers will be, Lord, fill us with your Spirit.
Lord, fill us with your Spirit.
For the whole church, that the fire of the Holy Spirit may come and renew all the baptized, as it came to the apostles and turned them into fearless heralds of God's wondrous deeds. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us in your Spirit.
For our Pope Francis, our Bishop David, and the clergy, that filled with the presence of the gifts of the Holy Spirit, they may always build to greater communion among all Christians. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us in your Spirit.
For all us Christians, endowed with a great variety of charism, that we may realize that all these gifts come from one Spirit and are meant to renew and build up the church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us in your Spirit.
For all peoples of the world, often divided by dissensions, that thanks to the transforming action of the Holy Spirit, they may seek ways of reconciliation and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us in your Spirit.
For all men and women of goodwill, that guided by the Spirit, they may work together for a new world filled with justice for everyone, especially for the poor. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us in your Spirit.
For those who are discouraged, depressed, and faint-hearted, that they may experience in the fragility of their life the power and strength of the Holy Spirit who challenges them to go out of their isolation. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us in your Spirit.
For our catechists and all those who preach the gospel, that the Holy Spirit may fill them with enthusiasm and make their ministry fruitful. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us in your Spirit.
For those who are preparing to receive the sacrament of confirmation, that they may be strong in faith and through prayer grow in their desire to live their Christian life to the full. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us in your Spirit.
For all the groups and movements of our parish, that they may be open to the working of the Holy Spirit as they carry out the mission entrusted to them by the risen Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us in your Spirit.
For all of us, that through the Eucharist, we may open our hearts to sanctifying action of the Holy Spirit in order to grow in holiness and continue the evangelizing mission of the Lord. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us in your Spirit.
Hail Mary.
Lord, praise the Lord is with you. Blessed are you amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and in the hour of our death.
Heavenly Father, we ask you to receive these in all our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray that this our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for all the women and the Holy Spirit Church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that as promised by your Son, the Holy Spirit may reveal to us more abundantly the hidden mystery of this sacrifice, and graciously lead us into all truth. And we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for bringing your Paschal mystery to completion, you bestow the Holy Spirit today on those you made your adopted children by uniting them to your only begotten Son. This same Spirit, as the Church came to birth, opened to all people the knowledge of God and brought together the many languages of the earth in profession of the one faith. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every man, every people exalts in your praise. Even the heavenly powers and the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they are praying.
Thank you.
Lord, you are
takes away the sins of the world, blessed are we who are called to this supper of the Lamb. For you, Christ, bring us to life and bless.
Prayer before Holy Communion. Act of love. O my God, I love you above all things, with my whole heart and soul, and with all my strength, because you are all good and worthy of all my love. I love my neighbor as myself, for the love of you. I forgive all who have injured me, and I ask pardon of all whom I have injured. Thank you. Let's all down for prayer to the Holy Communion. Soul of Christ, sanctify
me. Body of Christ, save me. Blood of Christ, liberate me. Water from the side of Christ, wash me. Passion of Christ, strengthen me. All good Jesus, hear me. Within thy wounds, hide me. Permit me not to be separated from thee. From the wicked form, defend me. At the hour of my death, call me. And bring me back to thee, that to thy saints I may praise thee forever and ever.
Thank you. God is good
all the time.
And all the time?
God is good and
that is his nature. Wow. Let's appreciate our choir for being able to come today. Today you are served by Friends of St. Augustine. Let's appreciate Friends of St. Augustine. We also want to take this opportunity to thank our parish priest, Father Kanja, for leading us on the Pentecost Sunday. Let's appreciate Father Kanja. And finally, let's appreciate ourselves for the active participation in this event. Thank you and welcome to today's announcement. The sacred period of 50 days, which is the Easter time, concludes today, which is the Pentecost Sunday. During the Pentecost, we celebrate the descent of the Holy Spirit upon the apostles and their followers, and it marks the beginning of the earthly ministry to make disciples of all nations. So as a church, today we celebrate the birthday of the Catholic Church. So happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Thank you. Next Sunday, we'll be celebrating the solemnity of the Most Holy Trinity. We'll start with announcements from the parish office. Masses for the week, on Tuesday, 25th of May, we shall have Mass for St. Anthony of Padua at 6:30 p.m. in the chapel. On the same day, 25th of May, Tuesday, we shall have Mass for St. Augustine at 6:30 p.m. in the main church. On Thursday, 27th, we shall have Mass for St. Jude at 6:30 p.m. in the chapel. On the same day, Thursday, 27th, we shall have Mass for St. Maria Goretti at 6:30 p.m. in the main church. Finally, we shall also have Mass for Immaculate Heart of Mary at 6:30 p.m. at the Kindergarten Hall. We are being reminded that confessions are ongoing every Saturday from 4:30 p.m. at the Grotto. So anyone who wishes to participate in the sacrament of confession, please note that confessions are open from 4:30 p.m. at the Grotto. An announcement from the parish office, PMC resumed their meeting yesterday and they'll be meeting every Saturday at 1:30 p.m. Announcement from the catechist's desk. Catechism classes for the children have already resumed. We have classes at 9 a.m. and 11 a.m. for sacrament of baptism and first Holy Communion respectively. Whereas the classes for the sacrament of confirmation will start at 2 p.m. The adult catechism classes resumed on Wednesday, 12th of May at 11:30 a.m. for the first group and 6:30 p.m. for the second group. Those who are yet to join will do so as soon as possible. You can register with our catechist after the Mass or at the parish office downstairs. CMA announces to us that the commission classes will start next Sunday, which will be 30th of May, and registration is currently ongoing at the CMA desk. They're also announcing to us that the St. Joseph Technical College t-shirts are still available at the CMA desk, and they are being sold for 1,000 shillings only. All of us are requested to support our CMA towards the noble project of putting up a technical college in Kamundo. Sacred Heart of Jesus Devotion Group will have their meeting today, or rather the meeting is ongoing. It started at 11:45 a.m. at the Grotto. Announcement from the lectures. Lectures meeting will take place on 6th of June after the first Mass, and new members are welcomed to join. Enrollment will take place during the meeting. Those who wish to be part of the proclaimer ministry are encouraged to pick up lectures forms from the parish office. You're supposed to complete them and return them on the meeting day. And for all the juniors who not nominated lectures, kindly ensure at least your Jumuya has a letter. All those who took the Lenten campaign boxes have been invited to bring them back. The Lenten campaign boxes can be dropped outside the church or downstairs at the parish office. Next Saturday and Sunday, St. Augustine will be serving us. Marriage vows. He announced marriage between Mr. Kevin Kuria, son of Mr. and Mrs. Peter Maura, and the late Esther Wanja, who intends to marry Mrs. Mary Agnes Nkata, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Zachary Wutua and Mary Wutua. Anyone with any objections as to why the two should not solemnize their marriage in church, kindly get in touch with our parish priest or any of the priests available in the parish. Announcement from our assistant chief. We have been reminded that the Huduma number files are ready, and those who have received an SMS, you are being requested to collect your card from the offices. For those who didn't register, phase 2 is coming soon. And for those who haven't received the SMS, you are requested to keep calm, and once you receive the SMS, your card should be ready for collection. Those are the announcements for this week. God is good.
All the time.
And all the time.
God is good and
that is nature.
Wow.
Wish you a blessed week and a fruitful week ahead.
Thank you. Walk in the light, walk in the light, walk in the light.